speak on behalf of the 99% who are occupying. We are the people who are not being heard in this committee. This is a secret committee. We are the people who are not being heard in this committee. We need to listen to our the people who are not being heard. We need our representatives to hear us.
This committee will come to order. Before we begin, let me just remind all our guests that the manifestation of approval or disapproval, including the use of signs or placards, is a violation of the rules which do govern this committee. So I want to thank all of our guests in advance for their
support. Altogether, the Treasury is spending amounted to about 9% of GDP in the past few years, higher than the 6% in 2000, but lower than the 11-12% of the early 1970s. The third question addressed in the testimony is how discretionary spending will evolve over the next decade under current laws. To illustrate the potential impact of the tax on discretionary appropriations set in the Budget Control Act, and the automatic proportional procedures.
I have that handout.
I apologize for those who don't have the handout. I think the members of the committee should have it in front of them. For other people, I'm referring to figures and tables that are in the written testimony, and there are a couple slides or words also from the written testimony. Nothing I'm saying is new is not in that testimony. The largest numbers that we looked at, about $12 trillion over the next decade, would come from extrapolating funding. Altogether, discretionary spending amounted to about 9% of GDP in the past few years.
Have that handout.
I apologize for those who don't have the handout. I think the members of the committee should have it in front of them. For other people, I'm referring to figures and tables that are in the written testimony, and there are a couple slides or words also from the written testimony. Nothing I'm saying is new is not in that testimony.
It's very obvious. I speak for the 99% in the wars and tax the rich.
Anyways.
Thank you very much.
Detention or arrest?
The day.
Thanks.
Good job.
Sarge, can you get a female ear for that dog?
So I think you're going to arrest me? Are you arresting me?
Yes, ma'am.
And what's the charge, please? Do you know what the charge is?
Sergeant will be here to explain.
So I just spoke for the on behalf of the vast majority of American people who want these wars to end, and they want to stop spending 50 cents out of every dollar on the war machine, and they want that money to come back home and to be spent on housing and health care and education. There are people sleeping in the streets in the most prosperous country in the world because they don't have any place to go, and this is absolutely abominable in a country as rich as ours that we are spending 50 cents out of every dollar to profit the war machine like Halliburton and Grumman and Boeing and Lockheed, while people are sleeping on the streets, while 50 million Americans have no health care, while people are dying every day because they don't have any preventive medicine. This is a shame. This is a shame and a scandal. All this is going on, and American people are tired of it, and that's why you're seeing people come to the streets now and speaking up and saying, we are standing up for ourselves, and we are saying, it's government, listen to us. You have to stop ignoring us. We have made our voices very loud on how we want our tax dollars spent, and you've been ignoring us all this time, and now we're saying you must listen to us. We want our money to stay here. We want our money to be used to uplift people, as Martin Luther King called us to do, not to destroy people. And I'm ashamed of what our government's doing. And this super committee, this super secret super committee of people that don't let the public know what they're doing, they're trying to say that they're looking out for the best interests of us, but only the lobbyists have access to the super committee. We don't even know when and where they're meeting. So today, finally, they let the public in to hear the super committee listen to the CBO. But who was speaking on behalf of the 99%? Who was speaking?
We don't get handouts.
We didn't get any handout. He kept referring to the charts and graphs that were in this handout. We had no access to that. The public didn't have access to that. And, you know, the public's not allowed to testify. This CBO guy is using all these facts and figures and percentages to obscure the truth of what's really happening. This government spends more on defense, what they call defense, but it's really militarism and war, than the rest of the world combined. And this is just a shame. It's a shame and a scandal. And, you know, we could solve our deficit problem today if we ended the militarism in the wars and started taxing the top 1% of people.
They talked about entitlement programs.
Yeah, entitlement, you know, like Social Security and Medicaid,
which we have paid for, but that they want to cut.
Absolutely.